The Center for Near-Earth Object Studies, or CNEOS, at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Southern California is NASA's center for computing highly accurate orbital data for thousands of asteroids and comets that fly close to our planetary neighborhood. CNEOS collects this information from the Minor Planet Center, which includes orbital data and basic physical properties like size and rotation rate. If you'd like to find out more about these fascinating near-Earth objects, you can go to the CNEOS website and check them out for yourself. The first thing you'll notice on the CNEOS homepage are the top news stories. These articles describe some of the more recent and notable near-Earth objects, or NEOS, that have caught the eye of NASA astronomers. But one of the most useful pages is the one that lists all the upcoming close approaches. Understanding future near-Earth object close approaches is important because astronomers can then better plan and when to study them as they fly past. Click on Close Approaches and then NEOS in the navigation bar. Each line provides information about the close approach of an NEO, and by default they are sorted by time. The first column gives the name of the NEO, and the second gives the date and time of its closest approach. It's worth noting that 99.9% of the objects listed here are asteroids, and a very small number of them are comets. The next two columns tell us how close each near-Earth object will get to us. Note that the close approaches are measured in lunar distances, or the average distance between the Earth and the Moon, which is about 239,000 miles, or 384,000 kilometers. We also use AU, which is the astronomical unit. This is the average distance between the Earth and the Sun, which is about 93 million miles, or 150 million kilometers. This first column is the nominal distance at which the object will come to Earth. This is the most likely closest distance as it zooms past our planet. The minimum distance column provides information on the closest the object can possibly come during its flyby, considering all possible uncertainties. This state-of-the-art CNEOS orbital modeling is very, very precise. We know the orbits of most of these objects with a very high degree of accuracy. The final column provides an estimate of the object's diameter, based on how bright it is. These objects range in size from a few meters to a few tens of kilometers. But keep in mind that there are many, many more close approaches by smaller objects measuring only a few meters across when compared to the biggest NEOs measuring kilometers across. As this database contains a lot of information, you may also want to filter the table by time, nominal distance, and absolute magnitude, which relates to the object's size, by using the table settings options. Now you are familiar with how this page works, you can get more information about each of the objects listed on the left. So click on one of the NEOs to take you to the object's small body database listing. Here you will find a goldmine of orbital data. Click on any of the parameter names to find out what they mean. From here, you can even display an animation of your favorite asteroid or comet orbiting the Sun. So if you hear about an interesting asteroid in the news, come to the CNEOS website and look it up. Now you can verify the object's flyby distance and lots more besides.